if you look at succession now, if you take it outside of the political theater, you realize that succession has always been a challenge with mankind. Let me take quick examples. I can go even to the Bible. Even Jesus had disciples with him, and then some of them were lobbying for who would have the highest position when he ascended to the kingdom, to his father's right hand. And you would see over time, even from just everyday existence, in a house, you'd have sibling rivalry. Somebody is trying to gain the parents' love in a better way to be able to receive the bequeathing of other properties and stuff. So these things happen. It's human nature. These conflicts will arise. Every time there's a prize in sight, people will jostle for it. And it just so happens that because the stakes are higher in politics, that people go all out. To position themselves to be the recipients of either someone's legacy or decision to hand over power to someone else. Same way in Lagos State, for instance, we know that many people, in fact, the PDP candidate has been lampooning the APC candidate because he's believed to be a lackey or a puppet of former governor of this state. So succession will affect everything we do. In a business, for instance, you have someone, a chairman who's winding down from service, and then it happens that people within the organization, they have people they prefer to be in place. It happens in church as well, too. You have people who've been general overseers for a long time, and then they have a particular person they want to succeed them, and people are opposed to that because they believe that they're equally stakeholders in the process. So I think it's not difficult to observe that this thing occurs across different strata of human existence. The fact that it's political now is our focus this evening. And I think in Nigeria, one of the factors that affects us, that puts us in a bad position, is that people don't subscribe to the higher values of integrity, honesty, patriotism, hard work being a good thing. So because people don't subscribe to those higher values, we see over time that we cannot get the best crop of people to step into the leadership arena. If you don't have someone who's selfless, if you don't have someone who believes patriotism is rewarding and the right thing to do, you will find that people who come into the political space and just to be successors to those who are leading now will come with the same set of values. They don't respect the rule of law, they don't respect sanctity of human life. So those are the things that we should be trying to correct as a nation. How can we get people with the right values, who will uphold those values and push those values? How can we have more of them participate in the political process? I think.
Okay, well, I hear that since 1960, we've been facing this issue of, you know, succession, transfer of power, and most times it's accompanied by tension. And some researchers have said for Nigeria, the reason is because a lot of these people, a smooth transition in a democratic, you know, dispensation in Nigeria is very, very far-fetched because some of these leaders hate to follow the rules and the guidelines of a democratic process. They would rather, you know, want it to be done their way. But why are we in a democracy and we do not follow rules? Is it a Nigerian thing or is it a human thing?
It's a human thing, and I say that with...
But there are democracies in other places in the world, and the people follow the process.
It's a human thing. Again, I'll lean towards saying it's a human thing because of this thing I'm going to mention now. If there is no incentive to do the right thing, nobody will do the right thing. If there is not a system or a punitive system that punishes or does not reward evil, then people will not be inclined to do it. Mm. Outside of these shores, we find that people who are inclined to do the wrong thing in political spaces get sanctioned for it. In some places, they're even executed for it, they're killed for it. Here, we don't have that big stick, as it were, that's going to be wielded if people fail to do the right thing. And because there's no incentive for doing the right thing or reward for doing the right thing, people as... It's human nature. People will generally not do the right thing if there's nobody there to push them to do the right thing.
But we have laws in this country. We have codes, criminal, political. I mean, we have the Electoral Act. I mean, there's so many laws in this country.
The problem is enforcement.
Talking about the big stick here. Mm-hmm. Yes, we have laws, the punitive measures, but I think what you're trying to talk about is the willpower on the part of the people who are support all the institutions that are supposed to somewhat enforce these laws.
I've heard the argument that we get the leadership we deserve, and I've seen in different climes, from Turkey, I've seen different in France, for lesser issues, you've seen the people who the power really belongs to, the citizens of the country, they've stepped up and demanded for the right thing to be done, and we've seen leadership affected at the instance of the people. Here, and it's an offshoot of the years of military rule, where people are afraid to step out to protest, and if they do protest, they're afraid they're going to lose their lives. They're afraid there's going to be reprisal attacks afterwards. So those are the things that prevent us from demanding for the right thing to be done. Otherwise, you've seen times where people wanted. I remember this dispensation. People wanted to come out to protest something this government did, a policy, and then on the eve of that protest, or even on the day of the protest, we saw that people were disallowed from protesting. And one of the tenets of democracy is to be people are supposed to be allowed the right to protest. And we've seen over time that in this dispensation that. And that's one of the things that people are afraid of in terms of this succession planning for either political spaces, because people are afraid to come out and demand for the right thing because they know there is nobody to look out for them. There's no system in place. We have strong men and not strong institutions.
Now, we understand in Nigeria how religious and ethnic credentials play in determining who becomes the next leader and a whole lot more. Now, that has always been the bane of discussions and crosses over even those with stronger qualifications at the end of the day. But do you think necessarily we can wean ourselves as a people and as a country away from these factors that have dug their fingers so deeply that we lose sight of really what should be our objective and define our level of perspective when it comes to choosing leaders? Then we can't do any strong assessment at the end of the day if we don't have the leaders put in place that should do the needful.
I believe it's possible, but this country has been fractured, balkanized. I mean, dealt fatal blows in different places that cut across religious views, ethnic views. So it's going to take time for those wounds to heal.
Let's even take a look at even our appointments now by even the president, because that has also come under sharp criticism.
Exactly.
In the last 4 years, how do you think that has played out?
I mean, even a blind person, if you read out the names, if you put a sheet of paper on O'Brien and then you had someone read out the names of people who've been appointed into sensitive positions across the country, and they tend to lean towards one part of the country. And there's a statement credited to the current president that he would favor a certain people who voted for him more than those who didn't vote for him in the last elections. It creates the sentiment that this is not the time or place to believe in the values that can push for these things to be done away with. For instance, in the USA, affirmative action that allowed for people of color to be able to go to educational institutions, it was in place for quite a long time, and it enabled black people and minorities to be able to access education and other things as well. But we see now that affirmative action principle is no longer the operative principle. Now it's more merit. And in Nigeria, it's going to take some time. There have been wounds. You find statements being made, I mean, over time that hit the polity up across ethnic lines, across religious lines, and people.
Well, do you remember or do you still recall that just while we're having the whole campaigns and a whole lot more, these same lines that I say we've been hit are what has been exploited or explored on? Because at the end of the day, the politicians are saying that, well, vote for party A or party B, and come 2023, you are going to have a secured seat.
Well, politics will always appeal to different sentiments. People who are aspiring for anything will appeal to the sentiments of the people they're trying to get whatever they want from. So if they will say that, they will flatter you. I've seen men try to woo women, and they say all sorts of things, all sorts of nice things, and then when they get what they want, they are gone with the wind.
But we have this whole zoning thing in political parties, whether it be party A or party B. That again goes to buttress the fact that we in this country see things through the prism of religion, ethnicity, and of course, you know, those kind of things. So really, and the parties take advantage of it because this is who we are. Maybe if we were not these kind of people, it would have been easier to do away with it.
It would have been easier, but I mean, we're stuck with who we are now. Nigeria is an agglomeration of different ethnic groups, and a lot of the minorities have been oppressed for years. The only hope for many of them to receive some redress is for somebody who they believe is like them to be empowered, which is why, to a large extent, in the Jonathan era, a lot of people were sympathetic towards him, especially minorities, because they believed he was one of them. And then to a lot of people as well, to along from minority groups, his eviction from office, as they say, brought a sense of mourning for months in different parts of the country, because it was assumed, in fact, it's not just an assumption, many people still believe that he was kicked out of power because he was a minority. Again, some of the sentiments that were spewed after he lost or after he considered victory were reinforcing that same view as well, too. So I think it's going to be a matter of time. It's going to take time for these wounds to heal. We need a leader, and not just a leader, we need people who will come out and present a balm for the wounds of our nation. It may not happen.
But do you think necessarily we are objective enough to do such assessment? Because at the end of the day, we even look at the postponement of the election, which was supposed to have been held last week, Saturday, yeah. And we're looking towards this Saturday now. Some have also said, well, it is because of the appointment of Amina Zakari by the president, knowing this religious and ethnic leanings once again raising its ugly head. They are saying because of that appointment and not doing the right thing by removing that officer is why we have that incompetency that has led to this current failure. What do you make of such a stance?
It's not without reason, but if you look across board, the incompetence has become a national calling card for many of us. It's in different sectors. We can't run away from it. So to highlight this failure by INEC, it's a bit unfair, but again, it's deserved. However, this thing we're looking at is deeper than just politics. Because you have people in different organizations. In the civil service, people from a certain part of the country are viewed as untouchable. Because for years, they've been the mainstay in terms of power being rotated in civil service. So you have people from different regions who want to aspire for different positions. But again, you find that people from a certain region are given preference over them. So